We are in Washington, D.C. with Vinod Gupta, 1967 batch. And you have a philosophy of learn, earn, and return. Will you like to elaborate on that?
You know, we grew up in a village, and, you know, I was not born into any wealth. We didn't have any money. But the village provided the education, and I kind of feel indebted to all those teachers who were making $40 a month, and they gave a great education to us. And as a result of the education, then, you know, getting into IIT and getting education in USA, it allowed, you know, thousands of us to have a better living and be able to earn substantial wealth. But at that time, then you say, okay, if you have this wealth, what do you do with this? You know, if you give it to our kids, they're going to waste it. It's best to invest it back into our community, back into our villages, back into our students or the kids, so they can do the same thing. So they, if we have this philosophy of learn, earn, and return, and you keep doing it, you know, we'll leave this world a better place. You know.
You have already established Vinod Gupta School of Management, the law school, the medical school is coming up. What next?
Well, I mean, there's no lack of things we can do. I think the IIT system needs a lot more than just technical education. They need education, and that's one reason I set up the School of Management, that if you have engineering students, technology students, and they learn about management, it makes them a better graduate. Same way, having an intellectual property law education, since the world is moving towards intellectual property, and if they learn about intellectual property law, they can be a lot more productive, and they can contribute to the wealth of the country. I'm thinking they need education in different languages, because these students are going all over the world, and it'd be nice for them to learn Spanish and German and French and Mandarin and all these languages. And to have a school like that does not cost that much money, but it'll be good for them to get that education. I also propose that they should have a, as part of the law school, a library and a conference center, so they can have major conferences in the intellectual property law in the same school. I also suggested we should have a music school, so the same students who are studying, you know, spending all their time in learning technology and engineering, let them learn about music. You know, music is such a part of our lives, and having a music school would be great, you know. So there is no lack of things we can do at IIT system or in my village, you know.
And talking of IIT, I went to RK Hall of Residence, and the students were just very happy with you. They were calling you Saint Vinod Gupta. And all the improvements that you have done. Are you planning to go back and do something more there?
Well, you know that in the IIT Kharagpur, most of those dorms were built in the 50s, and they have not invested enough money in making those dorms more habitable. You know, the bathrooms and the dining hall and the kitchen. And when I went back and I saw those conditions, and I said, you know, this is not the right way of doing it. I mean, they need to invest and improve the facilities, but somehow the system does not lend itself to improving those facilities. They just think, let those students live in those little pigeonholes without any kind of quality, you know. And that was one reason I invested money in RK Hall, in improving the bathrooms, in improving the classrooms. And Suhas Patel provided the broadband connection to every room. And also the kitchen area, dining room, you know, provide some more televisions in the student room, in the common room. And what I suggested that every alumni should adopt their hall of residence and improve the quality of life there. So that means, you know, the whole institute, all the dorms will improve in the quality, you know. But then I ran into some problems here, because they have this hall council, And they said, you cannot just improve one hall, you have to improve all of them. And I said, I cannot improve all of them, but I can improve one, you know. And I would love to see more lawn maintenance, you know, get all the, you know, trash out of there. You know, make it a, you know, like a model hall of residence like we have in this country, you know. So I'd like to do more if I can, you know.
Now, shifting from IIT, if we, in your village, Rampur, which I recently visited, there is an extraordinary improvement in the quality of education. The Hillary Clinton School of Nursing, Bill Clinton School, there is a vibrant community that is growing. Will you like to say something about how that started? Where is it heading?
Well, I'll tell you a story. When I was there with President Clinton in my village, and when we were walking, and there was this guy selling vegetables on the sidewalk, and he called my name, and I didn't know who he was, and then he said, do you remember I went to school with you? And he was selling vegetables. And I told President Clinton, I said, look, you know, I could have been selling vegetables here. But it's because of education that some of us could get out of the village. Not everybody could get out. But I would like to see more and more children in the village, and especially the girls, get the quality education so they can get out of the village and improve their lives, you know. There's a lot to be done over there. There is no end to it, you know. But one thing I'm happy is that the government of India has given a major emphasis on education and healthcare, and we are seeing the results of that now.
Especially in the Hillary Clinton School of Nursing, the intake is 40 students, and hundreds applied. So it is a big step forward. So are you planning to expand?
Yeah, because first of all, I was not happy with the intake of just 40 students. I think we can easily educate, you know, 100 girls every year, and it's a 3-year program. Now we would like to introduce more healthcare related education, like medical technology, operating MRI machines, operating X-ray machines, testing, blood testing. These are some of the fields which are highly sought after. There's a huge demand for those, and they naturally lend towards employing women. So if we can educate more women, the village women, into these technologies, they will have no problem finding damn good jobs now. The other thing which I found was that once they get a good education, they're also able to attract better quality husbands. Like the guys or the boys from those villages who have gotten good jobs, and they would like to marry the girls in those areas, but if they have education, they can speak English, they can cook, they know the Western ways, then they find those girls to be a lot more attractive mates now. So even if they don't work, they can raise children and improve the quality of the next generation. You know.
In Saharanpur and in Rampur, when I went, there was a lot of talk about your dad, his influence on you, or in general as a human being. He's very well respected and all. Would you like to say something about?
Well, you know, growing up in the village, there were not too many educated people. And since he was very well educated in Lucknow University and the medical college, so definitely he had more respect amongst his peers. And the fact that, some of us got educated and they did very well in their lives, then the credit goes to our teachers and my dad, you know, that he did emphasize education. And that was our ticket out of that misery in that village, you know. So.
And the last one, what is your message to the present and the future students of IIT Kharagpur?
I think my message to them is that they should, first of all, they are extremely lucky to get a very high quality education at the expense of taxpayers' money. And I think every student should feel indebted to IIT system. And the only way for them to pay back is that they should, you know, give to IIT system as much as they can, whether it's financially or give their time or give their, any way they can contribute to the IIT system and make it a better system. Unfortunately, a lot of the IIT graduates, once they leave, they kind of forget about their IIT, you know. They just think they're done with it. No, we're not done with it. IIT system is like our mother, and we have to make sure that we go there and visit and contribute as much as we can, you know. So that's my message to them, you know.